heard Dick tell me, I'm Jason. Emily's going to be sitting over here driving for me today. She even drove the car. She's a big help. Altura, as some of you know us, we do a mixture of architecture and engineering, and particularly environmental, and we offer a variety of different services. The Chamber of Commerce's opportunity here has been outstanding, and so we're excited to show you some ideas here. One of the things that we want to start with as far as a general conversation is what I'm hoping you guys get out of this. Like, it's not just going to be a snoozer. And what you really have when you talk about infrastructure management, which is what I'm here to talk about, is you kind of have the stick situation, you have the carrot situation. Because all of your initial infrastructure is based off of a fundamental need to protect, you know, health, safety, and welfare. And what happens over time is that this long-lived stuff that you bury in the ground resurfaces as a major opportunity for business down the road. And I'm interested to show you a couple of stories of what that looks like. This is 1920, Houston Street. No, that is not the Riverwalk. This is what happens when businesses walk away from your city. They start seeing headlines that talk about, you know, destruction and so on and so forth. And that is one of the key things that you want to try to overcome. You don't want the cavalry to have to come to the aid of, you know, people standing at the Alamo anymore. You know, we're now moving to the age where, you know, the Alamo is doing a great job for us. So one major piece of infrastructure that is probably the most important piece of infrastructure in San Antonio commercially is actually the Olmos Park Dam. The Olmos Park Dam was built in 1926 in response to a massive amount of flooding between 1917 and 1920. And what was going on was about every 10 years a flood would come down and wash away downtown. And that happened over and over and over for a century. And by providing that, providing that protection, this, it used to look a lot nicer. Everyone sees it now. It's well engineered now. It was once upon a time, it was pretty. But this provided the opportunity to do a completely different kind of take on infrastructure in San Antonio. This is the beginning of the Riverwalk in 1938 for the WPA, re-envisioned for the hemisphere, and now it's a mature industry here in San Antonio. This is a piece of infrastructure, a dam that provided the opportunity, because you couldn't do the Riverwalk until you had that dam in place, until you could control those floodwaters. So here you have a piece of infrastructure that was put in the ground that turned into a major benefit for the community a generation or two later. We're really talking about what our grandparents have left for us in the past. That's a cool story. This is a personal story here. This is the Balcones Escarpment right here. This defines development. Hondo, San Antonio, Frat, Texas, San Marcos, Austin. Who's heard of Frat, Texas? One or two? Okay, yeah. Thank you. They brought in the highway eventually, and Frat, Texas grew up from just being a flag stop and a telephone switch and turned into Windcrest, Texas. And Windcrest, Texas, I personally have a big history here. My granddad built that water tower out there. He also built a big bomb shelter that no one even remembers. I was interviewing the mayor a couple years ago, and he didn't know it was there. A 300-person bomb shelter built for this. And, of course, the notion was that you had Fort Sam, and you had Randolph, and you had the 1960s. It was a great opportunity for retired military professionals to find a nice home and settle down and still be close to a post or to an air base. And so here you have this flow of the traffic. First you have the water infrastructure and the rail infrastructure. And then you have, you know, eventually a very different kind of story, because Windcrest has reinvented itself recently. Most people have no idea how important this iconic little building is. This is the Frat Internet Exchange. Remember I was telling you they had a switchboard? Southwestern Bell had a switchboard. Without that, now owned by AT&T, without that particular interchange, there wouldn't be Rackspace Castle where it is right now. A fundamental piece of communication infrastructure that most people would never even guess was there is really what's moving the needle for the east side of San Antonio as far as new business and the creation of jobs. Let's see, I'm far back. Oh gosh, I gotta catch up on this. But what businesses need to see is a good map. A map is like it's a treasure map from their perspective. Originally they were looking for water, then they came looking for rail. Now they're coming and looking for communications technology. These are the opportunities that businesses come and looking for, because they don't want to try to invent it themselves. You have to be able to make that accessible and communicable to them. And we have to reach out in a way that actually gets it to them. Now, most people here will be familiar with our typical mapping techniques that we use to help people get on the ground. You do an overlay study. You take a piece of land you know you want to use, and you start layering in all the different relevant data layers that you think is going to actually change the needle for how your client is going to occupy the land. Lay it all together, and you come up with an integrated map that shows you where you should be building what you want to build. The question here is, how do you find that right piece of land to begin with? This is a 500 square mile city. Well, that's the same question that Mr. Henry Cisneros, who was former president of the Chamber of Commerce, was asking. How can we help businesses who either want to expand in San Antonio, start in San Antonio, or move to San Antonio find opportunities? Where can they find that great infrastructure that gave us things like rack space, that gave us things like our river walk? We have to try and provide them some manner of a map. Now, we got a really fantastic team involved on this. CPS Energy, under the leadership of Bill Beneby, really did a lot of the grunt work up front and then brought our team on board. And we've been working with every major infrastructure provider in San Antonio, Bexar County, all the way up to working with TINRES at the state level. And the essential question here was, why aren't all these maps in one place? Why is it so hard to figure out where to get the data you need? And that really became the fundamentals. We know the industries that we're looking to attract to San Antonio. We know who they are. So our goals are to be able to illustrate that San Antonio is ready for them. Let them know that, you know, we have a plan for the future, be able to demonstrate that through a plan. And in that way, we help mitigate their development risk. If we can get them a little bit closer to actually making that phone call to the San Antonio EDF, then we can get them a deal, we can get them in, and we can get businesses growing in San Antonio. Connect them with the data that they need. That's where we're really at. Now, if everyone is interested, this is going to be the important part here, folks. We're going live.